As important as it is to be able to do statistics with JASP, you also have to know how to get your output out of JASP. We are going to talk about exporting datasets, results, figures, and tables, all of the techniques that you will need to prepare you for exploring statistics with JASP. For this example, we will continue using the JASP data file called Kitchen Rolls. If you still have it open from previous videos, then carry on. But if not, click on the main menu icon, open Data Library, and choose T-Tests. Select the version of the Kitchen Rolls dataset with the JASP icon in the corner. This is going to work nicely because there is already a Bayesian and a frequentist version of the independent samples t-test in the results. We have output, tables, and figures that we can work with. I do want one other table, however. Click on Descriptives to open the descriptive statistics. Move the variable Q3Check into the variables box by double-clicking on it, and then tick the option for frequency tables. Because frequency tables are supposed to be in descending order, show the data, and click on the variable name for Q3Check to show the value labels. To reverse order of all labels and place them in descending order, click on the arrows. And now we are ready. We have all of the output that we will need to learn how to export data, findings, figures, and tables. Because this Kitchen Rolls dataset is part of the datasets installed with JASP, it is in a read-only format. We cannot save it as it is. Our first export, therefore, is how do we export any data as a JASP data file? The procedure is simple enough. Main menu icon, Save As, Computer, Desktop, and then click Save. We now have a JASP data file saved to the desktop as kitchenrolls.jasp. You may remember that when we opened this dataset originally, there were already two analyses saved in it, the Bayesian and the frequentist independent samples t-tests. This is the advantage of using a JASP data file. When we saved this file, it saved both the data and the analyses that we had done, along with the results. They are still here and will remain saved in this JASP file format for as long as we use this file. Maybe we want to save our data as a CSV file so that we can open it with RStudio later on. That is also easy to do. Select Main Menu Icon, Export Data, Computer, Desktop. Name it Kitchen Rolls 2 and click Save. This saves our data as a CSV file named kitchenrolls2.csv. We could open it in R or in any other spreadsheet program. If you want to save the data to another type of format, here is the way to do that. Begin by showing the data. Double-click on any cell as if you were going to edit the data directly. This will give you an error message that invites you to create a new file. Click Generate Data File, and then save it to the desktop. The data will open in Excel, or whatever spreadsheet program you have installed on your computer. By using the Save As options in Excel, you can save your data in numerous other formats, from text files to an Excel workbook. Next, we are going to export the results. We want to use our findings in a paper, or on a poster, or we want to edit the tables for some other presentation. Go to Main Menu icon, Export Results, Computer, Desktop, and then click Save. Results will be saved as an HTML file. This actually gives you a lot of flexibility in what to do next. You can open these results with Firefox. You could post them on a website, for example. You can also open these results with Microsoft Word or any other word processing software. I could then use these findings in my class paper, thesis, or dissertation. You can also open these results with Microsoft Excel or any other spreadsheet software. This is the easiest way to edit tables, such as if I wanted to add an extra row for the data on score 2 in my frequency table. So far, we have exported the results in their entirety. I also have the option to export only the results that I choose. If I want to export a figure, click on the disclosure triangle. You have three options. Copy copies the image to the clipboard. I can paste it directly into my research paper that I am writing in Microsoft Word. Copy citations. Sometimes there will be citations associated with your image or your table. Copy the citations and paste them into your document. If nothing happens, then you know that there were no citations. On the other hand, if I copy citations from this table, then I will have some references relevant to the statistics in this table to paste into my references section. Save image as gives you multiple options for formats. If you know what format you want, and you have specific needs for a file format, choose it here. If you're not sure, but you want a good general image that can be resized and used in a class paper or on a poster, use PNG. Give it a name and save. You can now drag and drop the PNG image into your research paper. Your choice to export tables depends on whether or not you want to edit them and how much. Like figures, you can copy a table and paste it into Word. You can use the formatting tools for tables. Choose Auto Fit and Distribute, and then Auto Fit to Window. That will work for most applications, especially if the table is already formatted exactly as you want it. I want to do some editing on this frequency table, however. I have some specific changes that my professor suggested for APA style. I will copy the table and paste it into Excel. I'll give myself some room to work with space around all sides of the table. First, I need to get rid of the bold text. That is not APA style. Now, I need to address the columns. They copy in slightly weird, so I will cut and paste the header for each column into the place where it belongs. And that will leave me with empty columns between my data, which I will simply delete. Now I'm going to change the font. I want to use Times New Roman 12 point. Rather than have my total in the table itself, I am going to move the N equals 102 into the title of the table, and then delete the last two rows. These scores are presented with three decimals, but I can make do with only one decimal. Of course, every table needs a number. This will be Table 1. And the title should be in italics, but without a period. So that the title does not wrap later, I am going to merge the cells where the title appears. Now it is time to add lines, which Excel calls borders and APA style calls rules. For the top row of my table, I need a bottom border, a top border, and another bottom border on the last row of the table. So that all of the data fit, I am going to adjust the width of these columns, trying to keep them equal. Although this cumulative percent column needs a little more width. And that looks pretty good. Now I can select the entire table, including the title, copy, and paste into my class research paper. I no longer need this table number that I used to tell where this table would go. You know, these percentages need a percent sign. I can still edit the table in Word as I did in Excel. I'm going to right justify the column headers and then deselect the show non-printing characters formatting. And there is my finished table. I think I'm going to get an A on this one. Although, now that I look at it, I should have added the frequencies for the score of 2. Well, back to editing. We also have the option to export our tables in LaTeX format. If you are unfamiliar with this format, it looks like LaTeX, but it is pronounced either as LaTeX, or I prefer LaTeX. Either pronunciation is correct. To follow along with this, you need to have an instance of Tech already installed on your PC or your Mac. Installing and using LaTeX is the subject of another video, or perhaps a series of videos, so for now, I'm going to show you a cookbook approach to creating a table. Links are in the description if you want to learn more. As before, click on the disclosure triangle and this time choose Copy LaTeX. If I try to paste this into my research paper in Word, it's a disaster. To use LaTeX code, you need a LaTeX editor. Now I'm going to use Tech Studio. Sounds a little like R Studio, huh? There are many LaTeX editors available. I just happen to like this one. Tech Studio is open source, and it's available for all major operating systems. And it gives me the option to create new from template. And I am going to use the basic article template. This template opens with the basic LaTeX preamble required for any article, including the opening, in which I can give my new article a name, and I can ascribe authorship. Some of this other text I do not need for this simple table example, so I will delete it. Now I paste in the LaTeX code, which looks much better when it's formatted in an editor that knows how to handle it. Like R, LaTeX lets you install and use packages, and this table will require the package BookTabs. However, the use package argument needs to be in the preamble, not here. I will cut and paste it. Notice this text in gray. The percent symbol indicates that this is a comment or a non-printing note in my text. I will delete that too. Now I save my new Table 1 to the desktop. This also changes the working directory. And now, click on the green triangle to compile my table. LaTeX has created 5 files, including the one I am most interested in, the PDF of my table. Looks nice, right? But of course, there are still edits that I can make. For example, I need to add that row for the score of 2 that I forgot to add in my last example. Even if you are new to LaTeX coding, you can follow the example of what is already there and add the missing row. The colors help tell if you're doing it right. Compile again. And there is my updated table with the row for the score of 2. I'd like to get rid of those last 2 rows. Go back to the code and simply delete them, making sure that the remaining row ends with the double backslash. Compile, and the bottom 2 rows are gone. Oh, what about the percent sign for the percentages? If I type a percent sign, everything between it and the double backslash becomes commented out and turns gray. Instead, I need to use a backslash before the percent sign for all of the percentages. Now compile. And my percentages all have percent signs. Now there is obviously much more formatting that we could do, but this can serve as a brief introduction to LaTeX. Let's reflect on what we've learned. If you've watched these 6 videos, then in less than an hour, you've gone from being an absolute novice with JASP to becoming comfortable in the JASP workspace. Learning how to import data, set variables, select cases for analysis, and create new variables, and how to export your findings. You now know everything that you need to know in order to complete an introductory statistics course using JASP. So what are your next steps? I have created a playlist of videos that will take you from here. Descriptive statistics, inferential statistics, how to do 3 kinds of t-tests, ANOVA, correlation, regression, chi-square, and write up the results. I hope to see you in future videos, and I wish you the very best in your exploration of statistics with JASP.